Good morning, students. Welcome to recorded classes. Myself K. Rajalakshmi, lecturer of G. Pullareddy degree and PG college. I am going to teach you the subject Advanced Accounting for all BCom second year computers and general students. Actually, by this time, we would have been completed half of the syllabus. But due to this pandemic situation, we are unable to conduct live classes and we are also unable to come to the college to listen the classes. But we have to utilize this moment through these recorded classes. So first we will discuss about the syllabus of Advanced Accounting. So let us discuss the syllabus of Advanced Accounting. We have 5 units. First unit, Partnership Accounts 1, where we are going to learn about the types of capitals, then admission of partner, retirement of partner and death of the partner. Then come to second unit, again Partnership Accounts 2. In this unit, we are going to learn dissolution of firm, means how the company will be closed, and insolvency of all the partners or any one partner. Then third unit, we have 4 chapters. Issue of share capital, issue of redemption of debentures, underwriting shares and bonus shares. First chapter, issue of share capital. So what is the share? How the shares are issued? What are the types of share capital? What are the terms of share? All these will be learned in this chapter. Second, issue and redemption of debentures. So what is debenture? What are the types of debentures? What are the types for repayable of debentures? What are the types for issue of debentures? All these will be discussed in this chapter. Then third one, underwriting shares. How the shares are underwritten. Then fourth one, bonus shares. What are bonus shares? How they are paid? To whom they are paid? Then what are partly paid? What are fully paid? So all these will be discussed in the third unit. Now come to the fourth unit. Again we have 4 chapters. First chapter, company final accounts. I hope all of you know about final accounts which you learnt in first year. Degree first year. Final accounts are nothing but trading P&L and balance sheet. And you know the pro forma also, particulars amount, particulars amount. But here we are going to learn with a new format. Procedure is common, but the format is different. For sole proprietorship, partnership, you learned in first year. Now we are going to learn about for the companies. How the companies prepare final accounts. What is the format that will be learned. Then second chapter, profit prior to incorporation. So what is incorporation? How the profit will be calculated before incorporation? Prior means before. Then what is the profit after incorporation? These things will be discussed in this chapter. Then come to fifth unit, again 2 chapters. Value of goodwill, valuation of shares. So how the goodwill is calculated? Before calculation, what are the types? What are the methods for calculation? What are the different formulas for calculation? This will be discussed in this chapter. Then come to the second chapter of 5th unit, valuation of shares. Already we learned in the 3rd unit what is a share. Now here we are going to discuss the methods for calculation of valuation of share, different formulas. So this is about the syllabus. Now come to question paper pattern, where the question paper for 80 marks. Already you know that 20 marks for internal. Then the time for 3 hours. And we have 2 parts, part A, part B. In the part A, we have 8 short answers type questions, where you have to attempt only 5. So each carries 4 marks. So 5 4s are 20 marks per short, where you have to write minimum 10 lines per theory short answer. Then come to part B, where you have 5 long type questions. Each carries 12 marks, so long answer type 60 marks. But you have internal choice, 9th A or B from the first unit, 10th A or B from the second unit, 11th A or B from the third unit, 12th A or B from the fourth unit, and 13th A or B from the fifth unit. When come to the first question, 9th A or B, you will get from partnership accounts 1. Just now we discussed that under partnership account, we are going to learn admission of partner, types of accounts, retirement of partner and death of the partner. These are the models. Out of these models, definitely you will get any two. So, out of those two, very very important model is admission of a partner. That is very important and compulsory, you will get either A or B. So, you should be perfect in that chapter, in that model. Then come to 10th A or B from the second unit, that is partnership accounts 2, where we have two models, dissolution of firm, insolvency. So you get both for A and B. Then 11th from third unit, where we have 4 chapters. Out of these 4 chapters, first chapter is very very important, issue of share capital. Sometime you may get both A and B from the same chapter, that much important. So you should be very perfect in this chapter. Or only we have journal entries. No, we don't have any calculation part. Journal entries, power sheet. And very easy chapter. Very important and very easy. Then 12th question, A or B from the 4th unit, where we have 2 chapters. Company final accounts. So you will get both these in the 12th A or B. Then 13th A from the 5th unit, where we will get both for A and B. But for goodwill, sometimes you may get problem, sometimes you may get theory. But theory also related to the problem, means what are the different steps to calculate, what are the different formulas. So that nothing but a problem, but in a theoretical way. So you should learn in both the problematic way and theoretical way. So if it is theory, minimum 3 or 4 pages you have to write. So this is about the syllabus and question paper pattern. After this we are going to discuss introduction of first chapter, partnership accounts 1, in depth. Till now we discussed about the syllabus and question paper pattern. Now we are going to discuss introduction of partnership accounts 1 in depth. So first let us discuss about the meaning. So meaning, what is the meaning? When two or more partners join together to carry on business, then it is called partnership. So already you are aware of sole proprietorship. For sole proprietorship, how many partners? Only one person. With one person, he can do the business. That is called sole proprietorship. But for partnership, minimum 2 members are needed. That is the meaning. Then definition. Many scholars have given different definitions. Then we will discuss in a... Then features. So what are the features? Essential features are first one, persons. So just now I told that for partnership 2 members are needed, minimum 2 members. But maximum, what is the maximum limit? So for ordinary type of business, 20 is the maximum. 20 members can do the any ordinary type of business. And banking only 10, minimum 10, sorry maximum 10% can do the banking business. So this is the limit of maximum. Then agreement, when 2 persons or more than 2 persons are joining, so many clashes, many disputes will arise, difference in opinion. So to avoid all these things, they have to made an agreement. So agreement contains some rules and conditions, regulations, terms, So strictly they have to follow without any dispute, without any clashes. So agreement is compulsory. Then share or ratio. So in future, if profit or loss, whatever occurs, whatever arises, then how they are going to distribute? Suppose 10 members are there, 1 lakh amount is a profit. How they are going to distribute? So their share or ratio will be decided. Then business. So whatever the business they started, which type of business, means lawful or unlawful. Lawful means permission given by the government. Unlawful means where the permission or the sanction not sanctioned by the government, approval. So compulsory they have to take the approval from the government. Government should give the license. If there is no approval, then it will be considered as unlawful business. Then management. Suppose 10 partners are there. Each partner has to take the active part, or sometime all together they will appoint one partner as an active partner. So on behalf of all the partners, that partner will do the work. So he will get some salary or remuneration. So these are the essential features of partnership. Then come to partnership deed. Next topic, partnership deed. I hope all you know about the partnership deed. Nothing but agreement. Just now we discussed the second feature, agreement, which is compulsory. Why? To avoid the clashes, to avoid disputes among the partners. So what are the important clauses it contains? First one, the name of the firm. Whatever the business they started, the name will be given to that business. That name will be mentioned in the partnership deed. Then next, the nature of the business. What type of business? Because just now we discussed lawful or unlawful. So to know the government for tax purpose, they have to mention the nature of the business. Then amount of capital. Each partner, how much amount they brought into the company. Then ratio. So how, in which ratio they are going to distribute profits and losses. Interest on capital. So if any partner contributes a huge amount in the form of capital, so is the interest on capital allowed or not? That will be mentioned. Then loan and rate of interest. Capital is different, loan is different. Besides the capital, if any partner is interested to give the loan to the company to expand the business, in such case he can give the loan. So in return he will get some interest. So but that interest rate is fixed, 6%. Whatever the amount he will give, without any consideration of the amount, always the loan rate, interest rate is 6%. Then amount of drawings. So if any partner withdrew the amount for his personal use, then that drawings amount also mentioned. How much withdrawn, what, on which date, what is the purpose. Then salary or remuneration. Just now we discussed, sometimes only one partner can take active part. In such a case, he will get the salary or remuneration. Then ninth one, insolvency and their rules. Insolvency means any partner becomes financially poor, means unable to pay the debt. We don't have money to pay the debt of the company. So in such case, what is the rule that other partners has to do? So if all partners becomes insolvent, then the company will be closed because they don't have money to run the company. So if one partner becomes insolvent, what the other partners have to do? So those will be explained in their rules. Then preparation of accounts and audit. So how the accounts are to be prepared? What are the different methods? For example, depreciation. For depreciation, we have many methods to calculate, like straight line method, diminution method. So in which method they are going to calculate? So what is the method they are following, that will be mentioned. And audit. Audit means nothing but checking accounts. After preparation of accounts, is the auditor needed? If it is large company, because daily many transactions will be there. So for single person it is not possible. For accountant it is not possible. Even though if it is possible, he may not sincerely check the account. So in such cases, frauds and errors will occur. So there is a chance of fraud. So to avoid these frauds and errors, company needs audit, so that all accounts should be clear. All accounts should disclose true and fair view. That will depend on the partners. If they want to do, they want to get their accounts audited, they can. If all partners does not want to get their accounts audited, then no need to do any auditing. So these are the important clauses in the partnership deed. Now comes to the rules which are applicable in case of absence of agreement. These are the rules where there is an agreement. Now, if without agreement, suppose a very small business, they don't want to do any agreement. So how they are going to conduct? What are the rules they have to follow strictly? First one, equal ratio. If there is no agreement, no ratio. Then how they are going to distribute profits? Means they have to distribute equally, either profit or loss. Whatever the amount of capital, irrespective of amount of capital, they have to distribute profits and losses in equal ratio. Then no interest on capital. Just now we discussed one clause, interest on capital. If any partner will give a huge amount in the form of capital, he will get some interest. But here, if there is no agreement, no interest. Then no salary or remuneration. Why? Because in the absence of agreement, all partners should take active part. No partner is allowed to do any extra hard work. In such a case, no partner will get any salary or remuneration because all are participating, all are doing equal work. So no one will get any extra salary or extra remuneration. Then no partner is admitted. Means if they want to admit new partner, for example, their relatives or son or brother, whatever. First of all should together agree for that. If one partner rejects, so no partner will be admitted into the company. So these are the rules in the case of absence of agreement. After this, we are going to discuss types of capital account. Now we are going to discuss about types of capital. So there are two types of capital accounts: fixed capital account, fluctuating capital account. Fixed capital account. In the name itself, it is very clear that fixed. Fixed means capital, no change in the capital. Whenever any partner brought the capital into the company, that amount of capital will remain fixed during the term of the partnership. Till the end of the partnership term, that capital remains fixed, means no change in the capital amount. Every year the same amount carry forward to the next year, again the same amount to the second year, third year, like that it will continue during the term of the partnership. So there is no change in the capital amount. That is called fixed capital account. When it comes to fluctuating capital account, fluctuation means changes. Every year the amount of capital will change. That is called fluctuating capital method, where there is change in the capital amount. Now we will see the pro forma. Under fixed capital, what are the different accounts we have to prepare and what is the pro forma? First, fixed capital account. Under fixed capital, we need to prepare two accounts: capital account, current account. So because why we are preparing two accounts? Because the capital amount should be fixed. Capital amount should not change. That's why we have to prepare two accounts. One account, that is capital account, where we have to take only capital amount by balance brought down. Remember one point, always any liability, not only capital, whatever the liability like creditors, bills payable, loan, anything, always it will be taken on credit side. Opening balance will be taken on credit side. I will have learned in first year, but once again I am explaining. So by balance brought down, nothing but opening balance. Opening balance of partners' capitals will be taken on credit side. Then closing balance. In this account, we are taking only capital amount. We are not taking any other item. So whatever the opening balance is there, the same amount will be taken as a closing balance because it is a fixed method. Fixed means no change in the capital. So opening, closing both are same. Now come to the second account, current account, where we need to take the remaining adjustments. Adjustments of partners, not the company. Because already we learned in first year business entity concept, where owner is separate, company is separate. So company is separate, partners are separate. So here we have to take only partners adjustments, where the partner is receiving and partner is paying. So this account we have to prepare from the point of partner. So partner is preparing, in that estimation we have to prepare. So for the partner, debit all expenses, credit all incomes. So whatever the partner is receiving, those will be recorded on credit side. Whatever the partner is paying to the company will be recorded on debit side. So first we will discuss on credit side. So these are the ledger accounts with particulars amount column. So I just took only two partners, A and B. Suppose if you have three, like C, one more amount column. If you have four, one more amount. Like amount columns will increase, depends on the number of partners increases. So first starts with by balance brought down. This is a current account. By balance brought. Current account is nothing but loan account. Suppose all the partners, they have account in the bank. So that will be taken as a current account. So that current account balance, here we have to take. This will be depend on the question. In the question, if you have any current account balances, opening balances, then only you have to take this one by balance brought down. Suppose in the question you don't have any current account balances, so no need to take this one. Directly you can start from by interest on capital. Is it clear? I'll repeat. By balance brought down is nothing but opening current account balances of partners which will be given in the question. Liability side. If you don't have any current account balances, no need to take this one, this item. You just remove this. Then you can start from by interest on capital. Now interest on capital, already we discussed in a partnership deed. If any partner will give extra amount, huge amount in the form of capital, then he will get interest. So some percentage will be given in the question. That percentage is calculated on the capitals. Then we have to take those amounts in these amount columns. Then partner salary. This will also given in the question. So partner salary we have to take. Which partner is getting salary in that particular column we have to take. By P&L appropriation account. So before doing this account, we need to prepare P&L appropriation, where I am going to discuss later on after this account. So from that account, we have to take the profit to this account. So profit from P&L appropriation transfer to capital accounts. Then come to debit side. So these are all incomes. Incomes to the partner, because partner is receiving from the company. So that's why taken on credit side. Now partner is paying to the company. That's why it is expense to the partner. To drawing. When he withdrew, again he has to repay. So is it expense? So that's why taken on debit side. Interest on drawing. When he withdrew the huge amount, like in lakhs. So for that amount, every year he has to pay some interest. So company is receiving, partner is paying. So for the partner it is expense, interest on drawing. So these are all the partners' adjustments. So after posting all the adjustments in this current account, you have to make the calculation. So whatever the balance left, that will be taken as two balance carry down. So these are the two accounts where we have to prepare the fixed capital method. Next we are going to learn fluctuating capital method. Till now we learned fixed capital. So two different accounts we have to prepare, where adjustments are taken in one account and capital amount is taken in another account. Now we are going to learn fluctuating capital account. In the fluctuating capital method, we have to prepare only one account, that is capital account. No need of any current account. So capital amount plus all the adjustments where we have taken in the current account, those adjustments are also taken in the capital account. So when we club capital and current account, that is formed as a fluctuating capital account. All the items are taken in one account under fluctuating method. Let us discuss the account and their related items. First, by balance drawdown. For always, capital account starts with by balance drawdown. Nothing but opening capital of the partners. Now adjustments. Whatever the remaining adjustments are there, by interest on capital, then by partner's salary, by P&L appropriation account, that is transferred from the P&L appropriation account, nothing but net profit. Then debits, these are all incomes, that's why taken on credit side. Now come to debit side, these are all expenses to whom? To the partner, because we are preparing this account from the point of partner. So drawings, it is an expense to the partner. Interest on drawings also an expense to him. So these are the adjustments with capital. If you do the calculation together, then you will get the answer new capital, closing capital. Now here, once you observe one point, opening amount is some different. Closing amount is different. Is there any change in the capital amount? Yes, because this is fluctuating capital account. In the fluctuating, opening, closing capitals are not same. They are different. So, in this way, we have to prepare capital account where the opening capital, closing capital is not same. Is that clear? I hope you understand. Then we are going to discuss about some terms, some important points which are to be discussed in the accounts. Till now we learned the types of accounts and their performance. Now we are going to discuss some important terms which are to be used in these accounts. So first one, loan. Just now we discussed in the partnership deed, loan. Suppose in the case of any emergency, if the company needs amount, then any partner can give the amount in the form of loan. This is not capital. This is besides capital. Capital is separate, loan is separate. If that person gives the loan to the company, then in return, company will give some interest. Every year some interest to the interest on loan to the partner. So that interest should be always 6%. Just now we discussed whatever the amount of loan, irrespective of amount of loan, always the interest rate is 6%. So when this loan is mentioned, so in the case of absence of agreement, if loan is there in the question, then you have to take in the current account credit side, because partner is receiving. For the partner it is income, so we have to take in the current account credit side, only in the current account, not in the capital account. If the method is fluctuating method, in the fluctuating method where we are posting all the incomes on credit side. So this is also income to the partner, but we should not take in the fluctuating method. Remember this point. Always we have to show this loan, if given in the question, only in the current account. So credited. It is credited in the current account. I hope you understand. If not, I'll repeat. Loan is nothing but paid by the partner to the company in the case of emergency. Loan is not capital. Loan is the amount besides the capital. So what is the advantage to the partner when he is paying some extra amount to the company? He will get some interest on loan. So that interest rate always 6%. So in the case of absence of any agreement, if loan is given by the partner, then you have to take in the current account credit side. Only in the current account. I underline this. Not in the capital account. Okay. Now come to the next one, interest on capital. Already you know, whenever any partner will give a huge amount, when compared to remaining partners, then we will get interest on capital, depends on the agreement. If it is mentioned in the agreement, then only he will get. Suppose if there is no agreement, he won't get any interest on capital. So it depends on the agreement. Then drawings. Already you are aware of drawings. If any partner withdrew the amount for his personal use, it is called drawing. So for that amount, he has to pay some interest every year. Suppose he took 5 lakhs. So every year, like 10% or 5% depends on the company, depends on the agreement. So in return, he has to pay the interest for those drawings. But for these interest on drawings, there are 3 special conditions. How the interest will be charged, how much percentage will be charged, for how much duration it will be charged. So first case, beginning of the month. Suppose if a partner withdrew in the beginning of the month, like 1st January, 1st February, 1st March, like that. If the date is mentioned in the question, then you have to calculate only for 6.5 months. Per year will be given, but you have to calculate 6.5 months, depends on the date of the month. So this will be specifically given in the question, like beginning of the month but or the date of the month. So according to that, you have to calculate. If it is beginning of the month, 6.5 months. Second is ending of the month, like 31st January, 28th February, 31st March. If he withdrew in the ending of the month, then number of months interest will be calculated for 5.5 months. Then the third is middle of the month. If nothing is mentioned like 1st January or 31st January, if dates are not mentioned at all, then you have to assume as middle of the month. Then you have to calculate for 6 months. So these are the conditions applicable in case of interest on drawings. So these are the important terms. One more is fourth one, capital ratio. Capital ratio. Capital ratio, suppose in the absence of agreement, already we discussed that the profits and losses should share equally. Suppose in the agreement, if it is mentioned, profits and losses should share on capital ratio. On capital ratio means, for example, A, B, both are partners. A contributed 40,000 as capital and B 30,000 as capital. So with these capitals, we have to form a ratio. How they are going to distribute profits and losses. So just cut the zeros. 4:3. This is called capital ratio. In the agreement, if it is mentioned, or in the question, if it is mentioned, distribute all the profits and losses in the capital ratio, then you have to calculate the ratio in this way. Is this clear? I hope you understand. Then after these important terms, next we are going to learn P&L appropriation account. How the profit is calculated? What is the format of the P&L appropriation account? In the next class. Okay, thank you.